Hi, in this video, we're going to create a custom UI table view cell in Swift for the table view in our iOS app. This video builds on the last Swift video, UI table view tutorial using Swift 2.0. In the last video, we created a table view app that displayed several items that made us happy in a list. That's the code that we're going to start with. That code created a table view that lists happy things using the default cell style. This is really cool, but we can do much better. From a visual perspective, that app's kind of boring.
The first change we could make is to add an image to each cell. Now this is pretty simple. Every cell has an image property which we can add a UI image. We can define the image in two ways. In Interface Builder, we can select an image for our cells. That's easy, but we're more likely to assign it in code. Using the code from the last tutorial, we can add a line to cellforrowatindexpath to add an image to every cell. Both methods add the same image to every cell. A little more interesting than our original table view, but one image is boring. Let's pretend our Happy Things app has different categories for happy things. We'll use an image for persons, places, and things. I've added several image assets to the project, so we can just refer to them by name. To use different images, we need to create a class representing a happy thing. This will contain the type of happy thing as an enumeration and the thing that makes us happy. We'll also add the date it made us happy and a rating on how happy it made us, which we'll use later. We'll also change the array definition for our view controller class like this. We'll create the instances here. Now, if we go back to cellforrowatindexpath, we can use the property for our class to select which image to display. We have three images, but we can expand this idea to any number of images. If every happy thing had its own image, we'd likely store the image in the class, but the process is the same. In the last tutorial, we selected a cell style of basic, but we didn't talk about what that meant. Every UI table view cell in our table view has a cell style. There are four different cell styles: basic, right detail, left detail, and custom. We can define the cell style for a cell in Interface Builder by going into the Attributes Inspector and selecting the cell style that we want. The basic cell style is the style we have used up to this point. It contains a text field and an optional image. There's not too much to it. That's why it's called basic. Right detail cells look like this. They have the same text field as the basic cell style, but they also contain a detail string to the right. So we could display our happy thing and the date added to the right. Left detail cells are not that surprising. They start with our string in blue and then the detail string is to the right in black. Using our data, the cells would look like this. Subtitle cells move the detail string below the text like this. With the happy things data, our table would render like this. It's all interesting, but we really want to do something more custom. What we want to display is something like this. We want the happy thing above, the date below, and a rating of how happy this makes us to the right. We'll use hearts to display our rating. Hearts are a shape my paint program draws by default. The first thing we'll need to do is change the cell style to custom. This will allow us to create any cell style we want. And by anything, I mean anything we can create any view that fits into the table view cell and display it. Every UI table view cell inherits from UI view. That gives us a blank view. There's nothing there, but we can add anything we want. For this tutorial, we'll add two UI image view controls and two UI label controls. We'll position one image to the left and one image to the right. We'll also make sure the reuse identifier is cell. It should still be set from the last tutorial, but it's good to check. It's easy to forget something like that. Next, we need to create a Swift class file to represent this cell. We'll create an IB outlet for every control we add to the view. So that's the left and right image, the happy text, and the date text. Once we save the file, we need to make sure our cell custom class is set to the class we just created. It's in the identity inspector. Now we'll hook these back to our cell. We'll just control drag up our IB outlets to the correct control. We'll hook up all four controls. There's nothing crazy here. Now, if you remember the previous lesson, we set the label to our data in our data source. We're going to set the fields in our custom cell in the same place. The first thing we'll change is the class we're dequeuing to our custom class. Our cell no longer has text and detail attributes from the built-in cell types. We need to use the controls we just created, so we'll set those labels like this. The images will get added in a simple case statement. That's because we only have a few images. If we wanted to have a picture of every happy thing, we might store the image link in the happy thing class. Finally, we'll run the app and we'll get what we hope for. Maybe we should add a working app as one of our happy things, but you can add that as an exercise at home.
Okay, again, the source code is available on GitHub. If you have any questions, let me know. There's a warning indicating some layout issues. It doesn't seem to adversely affect the app, but if you know what to fix, let me know in the comments or submit a pull request. New videos are out every week, so make sure you subscribe. This puts new videos in your YouTube feed. I also have a newsletter on dg.com. I'll send this out once a month with links with the month's videos and any other tips and tricks that are not on YouTube. The newsletter list is not shared or sold, so you're only going to get an email from me. And with that, I'll see you in the next tutorial.